You've been seeing us a lot lately. In your school emails, at your free lunch sites, in your local newspapers, and even before the pandemic, in the halls of your state capitol, visiting your classrooms with politicians, the list goes on. But I bet you want to know more about what we do and who we are.
Since 2013, Teach Coalition has delivered close to $1 billion in government funding to Jewish schools in states such as New York, New Jersey, Florida, Pennsylvania, California, and Maryland. Our Teach state teams fight for government funding for historic programs, including record funding for school security, first-of-its-kind STEM funding, funding for nursing aid, funding for tax credits, funding for remedial services, important funding that our K through 12 students need in our states. And these states represent 90% of the Jewish day school world in America.
It's not about supporting a religious or a public education system. You must support both to have either.
When the pandemic started, we took everything we learned and put it to work to help our schools and families receive the services and funds necessary to meet the challenges of the pandemic.
It would have been almost impossible for us to function without their contacts and their lines of communication.
Certainly in smaller communities where there are fewer Jewish day schools, et cetera, we are very much an afterthought in the eyes of the local municipal governments, state governments, Department of Ed.
We are working around the clock, fighting for kosher meals.
Here's our great CBS crew, putting the lunches together for all children who need.
We're making sure that people of the five towns have food for their families.
Five food groups for lunch and three food groups for breakfast.
For access to technology, and are providing guidance to schools to navigate the many forms and relief funding that has been out there on a state and federal level. There's still so much more to do.
The one thing that this pandemic reinforced for us is that schools of tomorrow are going to look really different from schools of yesterday and today for so many reasons. We count on Teach Coalition so often, and we will continue to do so as we move into the future.
51% of jobs that exist today could be automated tomorrow. That means that we have to think about how we're teaching our students. We have to think about the skills that we're teaching them.
You know, it's so hard to be connected to your district. When you get to walk into a school and see all your efforts come to fruition, it's beautiful.
We need your help to continue to fight for our schools and families and to make sure that every child has access to a strong, secure Jewish education.
What we've seen since the 2016 election is that the power to move mountains is with the people. It is literally about all of you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Executive Vice President of the Orthodox Union, Rabbi Moshe Hauer.
Good morning. Good morning, everyone. It's such a privilege to be on with all of you. Such an incredible, amazing group of students, of schools, of the school, of the day school and yeshiva community. The story that all of you tell, the story that all of you are a part of, is perhaps the greatest story of the American Jewish community of the 21st century. It's a story of a community that values its faith and values its education, that is committed, has committed a tremendous, tremendous sacrifice, a tremendous commitment of communal, familial, personal resources to be able to see their students educated and raised in an environment that speaks to their Torah, that allows them to grow in their Torah and in their Jewish connection. At the same time, as they receive an outstanding education to be strong and capable participants in the American enterprise, in the community as a whole. Each and every one of you, each and every one of the students that's here on the call, your commitment, your presence in your school community speaks to the value that you place on your future, on your Jewish future, and as well your commitment to your education. We're here today, virtually in Albany, to express gratitude to all those in government who recognize the value of this school community and who are moving forward and who we must continue to encourage to move forward in supporting and encouraging this effort, this assumption of responsibility of our community and our families to educate our children in the best way, to educate our students to be strong participants in life. The community seeks and welcomes and appreciates the partnership of government in this incredibly important enterprise. I'm so glad, we are so glad. The Orthodox Union is very, very grateful to each of the schools for the work that they do day after day, and to each of you, the precious students about whom this is all about, for who you are, for who you will be, and for joining us here to make the case in a compelling way to our representatives, to our elected officials. Thank you. Special thank you to the TEACH team under Maury Litwack. May we see much success and much growth all together. Hope to be with you in person in Albany, God willing, soon in the future.
Thank you, Rabbi Hauer. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the TEACH NYS Executive Director, Maury Litwack.
Thank you, Sydney. My name is Maury Litwack, and I'm a yeshiva parent who's here to make their voice heard. Are you here to make your voice heard? Today, you will hear from some of the most impactful and important people legislating and helping to run one of the largest states in America. It's not just one of the largest states in America. Did you know that the New York budget is so large that it's $177 billion, with the B, dollar budget exceeds that over 201 world nations, over 201. Why are these important people speaking to you and with you? Why do they want to hear from you? Because you showed up. Not everybody shows up. And people who've been with us to Albany before know that when you're roaming the halls of Albany or you're on a virtual mission, you're one of the few who takes the time and shows up. But you know why else these important elected officials are meeting with you? Because you didn't just show up. You did so together with yeshivas and Jewish day schools across the state. You are sitting in your classroom with your classmates, and you may think there's just your class here today, or maybe a yeshiva or day school in the neighborhood, but there are students sitting in their classroom right now in Brooklyn, Rochester, Riverdale, Muncie, New City, Westchester, the Upper West Side, the Upper East Side, in Albany, in the Five Towns, in West Hempstead, in Great Neck, in Far Rockaway, in Queens. That's powerful. Unity is powerful, and you are representing such a large voice of not just the students in the mission today, but throughout the state. Did you know that there are over 400,000 non-public school students in the state, which include over 170,000 yeshiva and day school students? Showing up is powerful. Uniting is powerful. And those things are why you have an opportunity today to engage with these important elected officials. That's why they want to hear from you. But guess what? You have an opportunity to not just hold a meeting, but hold a transformational meeting, a meeting that these elected officials will remember and that will make a powerful impact. Imagine if today you don't just speak, but you speak with passion. Imagine if today you don't just ask for legislation to pass, but you truly explain what it means to you. Imagine if today you raise your voice. So I'm here to welcome you all and ask, are you ready to raise your voice? Now, usually I can hear you clap back when I say your school as we stand in the auditorium together, but I know how passionate this group is. And I know that even if you're on mute, you're gonna clap, we're gonna hear your passion. So I'm ready to do one of my favorite parts of this mission, which is to shout out all of the schools that we have here today. So I think we have our slide deck here. Let's see here. Here we go. So I have a question. Is the Shar ready to raise their voice today? Is Barkai Yeshiva ready to raise their voice? Thank you. And please feel free to unmute yourself. Is Beit Shraga Hebrew Academy, the Capital District, ready to raise their voice today?
Woo!
Yeah. Is Sierra Katora of Rochester ready to raise their voice today? Is DRS, ready to raise your voice today. I can see a lot of passion there. Is Hafter ready to raise your voice?
Yeah, go Hafter. Yeah.
Is the Hebrew Academy of Nassau County, Hank, ready to raise your voice today?
Yeah. Woo!
Is Indu ready to raise your voice today? Thank you, Indu. Is middle school ready to raise their voice today? Fantastic. Is Mag and David Yeshiva High School ready to raise their voice today? Is Manhattan Day School ready to raise their voice today? Was Al Day School ready to raise their voice today? Mill Basin Yeshiva Academy. I'm through the M. My voice better be sore by the time I'm done. Hebrew Academy, middle school, ready to raise their voice today. Is Ramaz ready to raise their voice today? Is Ramba ready to raise their voice today? Is SAR middle school ready to raise their voice? Is SAR high school ready to raise their voice today?
SAR.
Thank you. Is Shalom High School for Girls ready to raise their voice today? Thank you, Shalom. Is SKA ready to raise their voice today? Yay! Thank you, SKA. Is the Solomon Schechter School of Long Island ready to raise their voice today?
Yeah!
Thank you. Is the Solomon Schechter School of Manhattan ready to raise their voice today?
Yeah!
We're almost done. Is the Stamma Schechter School of Queens ready to raise their voice today? Okay. Is the LaFell School ready to raise their voice? The LaFell School has been with us so many missions. Are they ready to raise their voice today?
Almost. We're almost ready. Almost.
Almost. Okay, good, good.
We're getting there.
Western School ready to raise their voice. I see Danny up there. Thank you, Danny. Are we at the end of the list? Did I miss anybody?
Western Community High School, yay!
Yeah!
Westchester Hebrew High School, are you ready to raise your voice?
Yeah.
Yeshiva Har Torah, are you ready to raise your voice? There are a lot of Yeshivas coming up. Yeshiva Central Queens, are you ready to raise your voice? Bush Middle School, are you ready? And Yeshiva Pfeffer-Amato High School, are you ready to raise your voice?
Ooh.
Fantastic. And finally, I think we did our shari. If you are ready to raise your voice and you're passionate, you can change the world. You can change and make an impact today, and these conversations are so critical. You're about to hear from elected officials. You're about to hear from some amazing elected officials who can convey to you what your voice does and the impact it makes when they're governing and when they're working on these on legislation that impacts your neighborhood, your family, your friends, and your school. It gives me great pleasure to introduce one of those elected officials right away, right out the gate, Senator Shelley Mayer. Senator Shelley Mayer, who's my friend and I've known for a long time and has been in our community for a very long time, has been a champion for children and education throughout her time in the state legislature. From 2013 to 2017, Senator Mayer served as the chair of the Assembly Education Subcommittee on Students with Special Needs. In 2019, after being reelected to the state Senate, Senator Mayer was appointed to the Senate Majority Leader to serve as the chair of the State Senate Education Committee. She works with her colleagues to deliver the resources and policies school districts throughout the state need to provide a quality education for every child, regardless of zip code. For every child, regardless of zip code. That's who Senator Mayer is. Senator Mayer has consistently fought for resources for every single child in New York State. Senator Mayer has consistently fought for STEM education for all and for resources for the health and safety of every single child. Throughout the pandemic, every student in New York State has had a champion of the corner fighting for them in Senator Mayor. At our prior mission to Albany, she addressed our students with these words, quote, "I'm committed that every student in this state, public or private, get the best education they can." Ladies and gentlemen, that's a fighter for all kids. Ladies and gentlemen, that's a leader. Senator Mayor, close to 1,000 students and lay leaders are watching this live feed, and even more will watch it afterwards. And I know they're welcoming you with the same passion that you fight for our kids in Albany. Ladies and gentlemen, Senator Shelley Mayer.
Thank you, Maury. Thank you for that very generous introduction. It's great to see everybody. I wish I was seeing you in Albany in that big hall. Several years, hundreds of students, mostly students, teachers, board members, and it's so great when you're there to have your voices heard. But we can't do it this year, so we're gonna do it this way. But let me just say something and thank Maury and thank Sydney for their leadership. You know, this is a chance for your voice to be heard. You could be in seventh grade in a yeshiva, a Jewish day school, anywhere in New York, and your voice counts as much as anyone's. You can be in ninth grade in Westchester County, where I represent, in a yeshiva or Jewish day school, and I want to hear your voice. Your voice really matters to every one of us and my colleagues who are on this call today. You know why? Because we have an obligation, as Maury said, to ensure that you have the best education you can. And we are committed to helping all of our students, including our students who are here today, to get everything they are entitled to. You have made it through a very tough year. And I want to thank the teachers, the school directors, principals, and superintendents, all who are on here. Thank you for helping our kids make it through this year. And thank you to our kids for being resilient and strong and thoughtful and doing the best you can. But at the end of the day, you know what our obligation is as state elected officials, and for me as the chair of the Senate Education Committee? To fight for you, to fight for you to get what you deserve and what you need. Whether it's STEM funding, as Maury mentioned, that is so important, that you have top science teachers, that the state helps pay for them, that they come in and take advantage of teaching you everything you need to be successful as a student when you go on from high school. We want to make sure you have the security you need in your schools. We want to make sure that anti-Semitism is part of the conversation in every school, that is part of the curriculum. No one should forget about the rising tide of anti-Semitism. We are fighting for that with the State Education Department. So your voice really matters. And don't think that because you are either too young to vote, too young to organize, or a student in school, whatever grade, that your voice is not important. This is an opportunity today for you to make sure that for me and my colleagues who are here, who are your supporters and champions, that we know you're out there. We know you're out there and we know what you need and deserve, and it is our job to fight for you. So I'm gonna do my best to continue to be a leader for all of the students of New York, the students in public school and the students in non-public school, particularly to fight for funding for our non-public schools to do the things they need to do for STEM, for security, for particular educational needs, and also to make sure that our students with special needs get the attention and the special education they need. But it's my honor to be with you. I really want to speak on behalf of my entire Senate Majority Conference. I know some of my colleagues will be on, and the Senate Majority Leader, Andrea Stewart-Cousins, who gave me the honor to be the chair of Senate Education. That's because she knew I would stand up and fight. I'm not afraid. I've had a great partnership with Teach NYS, and I look forward to continuing to work closely together on behalf of you, the students. That's what our obligation is, and that's what we're committed to do. Thank you so much, and thank you for letting me come by and listen to you.
Thank you, Shelley.
Mayor, thank you. And for those of you watching live, we have fixed the situation and we can now admit more than 300 people. So come on in if you're missing out. I'm so excited and pleased to welcome both New York State Senator Todd Kaminsky and New York State Assemblywoman Stacey Pheffer-Amato, two of our biggest champions. I'm so excited for them to be able to talk to you about why they're champions for us and all about what they're doing for you behind the scenes. Take it away.
Hi, everybody. I'm State Senator Todd Kaminsky.
Hi, I'm Assemblywoman Stacey Pheffer-Amato.
And the Assemblywoman and I work together on behalf of the Teach Coalition to make sure that you have the resources you need to continue the great work that you're doing. We've been inside your schools too many times to count. We see the great work you're doing inside and out of the community. We see, you know, I've been in this now long enough that I've seen the excellent colleges after school, the great success in the world, whether it's someone who is a lone soldier, someone who's in medical school, someone who's become an attorney, someone who's built a business. We see the amazing work you're doing and we want to support that. And we mostly do that in two ways. One is through STEM funding and the other is through security funding to make sure that you are protected at all times. And in the last few years, we've gotten record levels of funding and we intend to do that again in this year's budget. So we're so excited to begin the work for you, to work for you again, to clear the hurdles and bureaucracy out of the way to allow you to reach your full potential. And we can't wait to partner up again and have great results that we could talk to you about on April 2nd about what we were able to do in this year's budget. And let me just end or turn it over to the Assemblywoman by just saying this. You make this happen. You have been a force. You have shown that you will not take anything less than the best from Albany to allow your education to rise to further heights. So we will keep working on your behalf. And it's wonderful to be with everybody here today.
Thank you. Senator Kaminsky said it great and the best about how much we expect from you, what you can achieve. But what he said was that we're a partnership. So just like all of you came here today, all the different schools for one message to us to let us know that education is important to you, we partner together because our voices are strong together. So under that leadership of Senator Mayer, honored to be here with her today. We don't always get to see each other. And Senator Kaminsky and all the other partners, we pull our voices together. Yes, we are the champions. We bring it up to Senator Mayor, chair of the committee on the Senate side, and for myself, Assemblyman Benedetto. But it's your voices that matter. Why? Because education is an investment, and we see that. And not to be like coin the song, but you are our future, right? So my investment today, our investment today in you is the future for our country, our state, for our young people. And I want you to achieve the most. And STEM is one way that we could do it because we know everything is going automated. And yes, we've been in your schools and I've seen you on the streets in Rockaway when we talk and tell me how much you love your science teachers and what you're doing. And it's very exciting to us. So we need to hear more from you today and tell us what your next priorities are. Because I think on April 2nd, we're going to have some great success to report back to you about what we could do for you right now. But I want to hear what else more you need, because we always have to strive for more. So thank you for the opportunity, Maury and Sydney. And thank you, Rabbi Hauer, for that introduction. But it's really an honor to be with everyone today. So thank you. But can I hear more yelling, Maury? Because I don't think I heard everyone. Can we just unmute everyone? I want to hear this too.
Legalize online gambling.
I'm motivated now. Your voice is that motivated me. And now I know what to do because I'm up here in Albany today. So thank you for that.
Thank you both so much. We are so honored to have you both. And we're not only honored to have you here, but we're honored to have you both as such strong champions for our work and our community. So thank you on behalf of everyone today. And ladies and gentlemen, please welcome State Senator Andrew Gounardes.
Good morning, everyone. Great to be here with you all. I think the last time we all got together like this in a group setting, we were in Albany and we were on stage, you know, in the auditorium in Albany talking about, you know, the lobby day and the advocacy day that you were all going to go go embark on. So I think that was like 2 years ago now. It's amazing how much time has gone by. Obviously, last year was a big challenge for all of us. But I'm really excited to be able to spend some time with you this morning. I know I'm meeting with a bunch of students from my district in Brooklyn later on this afternoon, from Mag and David Yeshiva. I'm excited to chat with you guys all. And I just want to say thank you. Oftentimes we feel like, and I was in your shoes, you know, a couple of years ago, many years ago, we go to school and we learn about government and it doesn't all really make sense that we don't learn how the pieces connect to each other and how what we learn in our classrooms relates to what happens in real life and how decisions get made. But this is a living, breathing example about how decisions get made. You all coming to advocate to us as to why the issues that you care about are so important allow us to then take that information and go back into the Capitol or go into our meetings with our colleagues and say, look, we have to do A, B, and C. We have to invest money in STEM programming for all of our students, including our non-public school students. We have to do this. We have to do that. And that does not come just out of thin air. That comes from you all. So I really just want to say thank you. It might seem like a drag, like you're all on video now and you don't know what's going to happen, but I promise you, your advocacy today makes a big difference. And that's something that I didn't fully learn when I was in your shoes. I went to a non-public school. I went to a parochial school. I went to a Greek parochial school that was attached to my church. We didn't have advocacy days like this. We didn't learn who our elected officials were. We didn't have a chance to talk with them and meet with them and explain to them what we care about and why we care about it. You have that opportunity, and I'm really, really grateful that you're choosing to spend this time with us today. And I can't wait to hear all the things that you're going to share with me and all of our other elected officials later on throughout the day. And you have to hold us accountable. It's not enough just to come once a year and say that you met with us. You have to meet with us. You have to call our office. You have to tweet at us or Facebook message us or Instagram us or whatever form of communication you feel most comfortable with. Make sure you find your elected official and tell them what you care about and why you care about it. You care about climate change? Let us know. You care about street safety in your community? Let us know. You care about funding for your schools? Let us know. Today is only one part of that journey, but I'm really excited to take that step with you all. And I hope you all have a great and successful day today. Thanks so much for having me.
Thank you, Senator Gounardes. Next, we have another special speaker for you. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome State Assemblywoman Taylor Darling.
Yeah. Hi, everyone. How's everybody doing today? Okay, I am so excited to be here with Teach NYS. I hate that I can't see you all in person. You guys are usually my livest advocates that come up to Albany, and I'm actually about to leave. I'm here in my district office, but I'll be traveling to my Albany office as soon as I am done speaking with you all. So I'm taking a mission trip up to Albany today as well, because our budget is, guys, very intense right now. Very, very intense. So I think that God definitely knows what we can handle, because to deal with everything that we're dealing with and have people in the Capitol and worry about our safety, it's like we really have been given just exactly what we can handle, because the most important thing that we do is advocate and make sure that we're allocating our funds, your parents' hard-earned tax dollars, your hard-earned tax dollars, to the issues that affect us all every single day. I do miss seeing you all in person. And I just want to say that there's nothing more important than advocacy. I couldn't have said it better than the senator who just preceded me. You said it right. This is something you should be doing every day. Never lose touch with us. Tweet us. We're on social media. We love to hear from you. And you are advocates in the best time to be advocates, because think about it, like 30 years ago, if you wrote a letter to one of your state officials and say you didn't get a response or the response you wanted, who cares and who knows, Now we can put everything out on blast. So we're able to hold each other accountable. We're able to work together, and we're able to make sure that each voice is really truly heard. And I have to say that I don't like to break people up by age, but I will say that the youth have been my biggest driving force since I've become an elected official. They say that the youth are the ones who push progress, and it makes sense, because we're thinking about our tomorrow and we're not
always caught up in the rat race that our parents and our grandparents can be caught up in. So I just have to say, like I said, you guys are usually my livest advocates, and I'm here for you. I want to know what's important to you. I want to know how we can push the dial forward, even in light of our economic and health crisis that we're still endeavoring. I want to make sure that you know that we are here and you guys are a priority, because you've made it very clear that your voice matters. And I'm just excited to be here today. So let me know what you need from me.
Thank you, Assemblywoman. We deeply appreciate it. And thank you to all of our distinguished speakers who spoke today. It is such a true honor to see such important individuals who make decisions on our behalf be so dedicated to our mission. Soon, you will all be entering your breakout rooms to begin your lobbying meetings. And lobbying might sound like a big word, but it really isn't that intimidating, and it's something that you will all be doing today. I know all of our attendees and students here are as bright as can be, and we're ready to jump in, but I do want to touch on a few key points on how to lobby effectively. In order for our representatives to take our issue seriously, we have to take it seriously too. Your presence here is a step closer to better representation and advocacy for our schools. We are here to show our elected officials that we care and we appreciate their support. So let me go over a few pointers with you. At your meetings, introduce yourselves, your schools, your community. They want to know about who they are meeting with. This is a unique opportunity for elected officials to see the ins and outs of what and who non-public school funding is directly going to. Explain your goal and why you are there to meet with them. You may meet with staff today, and that is okay. As Assemblywoman Darling said, we are in the midst of budget season, and elected officials are extremely busy working on your behalf. The staff member will convey your meeting to the elected official and is always a great point of contact to have in the office. Make sure you stay on message. Don't lose sight of your mission, which is government funding for non-public schools, or your message may get diluted. Share your STEM stories with them. The more personal, the better. Be confident and humble. Be confident in your right to lobby. If you don't know the answers to any questions you've asked, tell them you'll find out and you'll get back to them. After the meeting, say thank you. Send a thank you note, a card, an email. We will share with you their contact information so you can do so after this event. And most importantly, have fun. This is a unique opportunity that most students your age don't have the chance to take part in. We are so glad that you could all be here today. And without further ado, let's get lobbying. What we're going to do next is we're going to be going into our individual breakout rooms for your lobbying meetings. If a screen pops up and says join room, please click join when it appears on your screen. And we'll be bringing everyone back at 1 p.m. to this room for our keynote speaker, the Lieutenant Governor Kathy Hochul. So without further ado, we are going to enable the breakout rooms right now. And if you don't automatically get into your breakout rooms, we left this 15-minute break time for you and your school, as well as for us to get you into the right breakout room. So thank you all who are watching at home. If you're watching live, we'll see you back here at 1 p.m. for our keynote speaker, Lieutenant Governor Kathy Hochul. Thank you all, and we are going to enable the breakout rooms now. Hi, everyone. Welcome back to our closing session. I hope that you all had an impressive and informative and educational meetings with your legislators. I know technologically wise, not everything works out the way we want it. So if you didn't have your meetings, we apologize and we will make it up to you. But please know that your voices here, everything that you've done here has been impactful to say the least. And the legislators that are here today certainly see that. So without further ado, we are going to get started. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome UJA Federation of New York CEO, Eric Goldstein.
Thank you, Sydney. Good afternoon, everyone. really glad to be here with all of you. I first want to thank all of the legislators who've joined today to get a better understanding of the situation for hundreds of thousands of New York non-public school students and their families. Thank you to Maury Litwack and all the professionals and volunteers with Teach NYS for putting together today's wonderful program. And of course, thank you to the hundreds of advocates, community leaders, and educators who've joined today to make your voices heard. And I want to particularly thank the enormous number of students who are here who are spending their time advocating for this critical cause. It's really wonderful to see all of you. We all know that educating students across all channels has been disrupted this year like never before. And our day schools and yeshivas are certainly no exception. In the face of staggering challenge and almost daily unpredictability, the teachers and administrators at our day schools and yeshivas have been nothing short of heroic, putting aside their own issues and continuing to educate with excellence our children and grandchildren. Particularly at this moment, it's vital to remember that non-public schools educate almost 15% of all the students in our state, yet receive less than 1% annually of New York State's education budget. Over the years, UGA has worked closely with Teach NYS and our interfaith partners in the Catholic and Islamic communities to demonstrate the importance of state funding for our non-public schools. More recently, we've been meeting with legislators to help them understand the impact of the pandemic on these schools and the critical need for state funding for STEM education, transportation, and other key academic and operational areas. Philanthropy continues to do its part. Before the pandemic, UGA directed approximately $8 million each year to day schools and yeshivas through scholarship funding, benefits and supports for teachers, and other resources. In addition, in 2014, we created the $50 million Day School Challenge Fund, earmarking $20 million from UGA's own endowment as part of a matching pool to incent day schools and yeshivas to become more financially viable and build their own endowments. This challenge fund has infused an additional $84 million into the day school and yeshiva system. And just this past year, we allocated an additional $4.1 million in COVID-related emergency funding for increased day school and yeshiva scholarships and to help nearly 50 day schools and yeshivas cover the cost of safely reopening. But philanthropy can only do so much, can never substitute for government. We're now looking to Albany to continue its support for non-public school education so we can continue to successfully educate our children and grandchildren during these immensely challenging times. We at UGA fully understand the depths of the crisis across so many areas of need here in New York. We ourselves have been intently focused on helping to address many of these challenges. Since last March, we've allocated $67 million in emergency funding above and beyond our roughly $135 million in regular annual grant making to support critical social service needs, benefiting New York's most vulnerable, and also to help sustain our essential Jewish communal infrastructure during the pandemic. But we need government in this critical moment to do its part also to support the vital non-public school sector here in New York. It is for the well-being of our entire community. Thanks so much again to all of you for joining this afternoon with Teach NYS. And I think now it's over to Maury. Thanks so much.
Thank you so much, Eric. It is a true honor to have you speaking to us today. And it is a testament to the strong partnerships throughout the Jewish community that work together on behalf of the Jewish community. So now let's welcome back Teach NYS Executive Director, Maury Litwack.
Thank you, Sydney, as our special keynote guest here.
Yes, I am.
Oh, excellent. Amazing. Okay, so before I welcome our amazing keynote guest, I want to do two things. I want to thank all our speakers today. I want to thank Eric Goldstein, who was on one of the original Teach NYS missions when it was 7 to 10 people. Eric remembers when it was almost nobody coming to Albany. Eric was there before we were 1,000 people strong. Eric came to Albany. And I also want to thank just because I see him here as well. I hope he's still here. Senator John Liu, I see, is still here. Senator Liu, thank you so much for staying on with us. I know you did the meetings. Senator Liu,
I have to be here to support our governor, Hochul.
Our Senator Liu is a tremendous, tremendous advocate for education throughout the state for decades, and it's a real privilege to have him here with our non-public school community. Thank you, Senator Liu. I want to just get started. It is my great privilege and honor to introduce Lieutenant Governor Kathy Hochul. Lieutenant Governor Kathy Hochul began her career in public service on her local town board before serving as Erie County Clerk and then as a member of Congress for New York's 26th Congressional District. See, she worked her way up. So those, all the students who are asking, how do you become someone important like Lieutenant Governor Kathy Hochul? She worked her way up and started working in all kinds of politics and serving her community. Since 2015, she has served as the highest ranking female elected official in New York State government. Lieutenant Governor Kathy Hochul has successfully spearheaded numerous initiatives and leads the administration's economic development and job creation efforts across the state. She's working every day to advocate for policies that help all New Yorkers make ends meet. This is the fourth mission to Albany where the Lieutenant Governor has addressed our mission, the fourth. She's always a highlight of the mission. We always hear about, and people ask, is Lieutenant Governor coming back and speaking? And we are thrilled she could join us this year virtually. We're sorry, Lieutenant Governor, it's not in the big hall this year. In one of our past missions, Lieutenant Governor said that our students are the future leaders of the world, that she will continue to support and fight for our education, and that it was critically important that we help with state resources like STEM funding and security funding so our students can successfully pursue the jobs of tomorrow. Ladies and gentlemen, that's a fighter for all kids. That's a leader. Lieutenant Governor, close to 1,000 students and lay leaders are watching this live feed from Brooklyn to Rochester to Riverdale to Muncie to Westchester, the Upper West Side, Upper East Side, Albany, the Five Towns, West Hempstead, Great Neck, Far Rockaway, and Queens. I know they're welcoming you with the same passion that you fight for our kids in Albany. It is my pleasure to introduce my friend, Lieutenant Governor Kathy Hochul.
Well, Maury, that was the most rousing introduction I've received in my 26 years of public life, and nothing like putting a little pressure on, telling me how many eyes are on me right now. So that's really quite extraordinary. So thank you for the opportunity to say hello for my, is it my fourth or fifth time? I'm not sure, but I've been there for you because I believe in what you do. And Maury, you have transformed how people in government view private education, not just in our state, but in our nation. So I thank you for building on the strengths that you've brought to this process. And most of it has to do with coalition building. This is what I believe is the way that we can transform government and people's lives in the process, is to build coalitions across religious lines and cultural lines and bring people together toward a common cause. So Maury, my hat's off to you for the work that you do with Teach New York, building the coalition. It's been extraordinary. Also to my good friend, Eric Goldstein, thank you for UGA's role in helping us get our people through this pandemic. We have turned to the not-for-profits like yours, and yours is so influential and represents so many voices to help them survive, get through, help small businesses, families, literally get people food on their tables. So to my friends at UGA, thank you so much. I truly appreciate all you do. I know Rabbi Hauer may be on as well. I want to thank him for his work. But today is not about these adults. You've seen enough of them, young people. You now, this is about you. And I don't have real prepared remarks because I want to just go with the flow. And I heard Maury mention that some of you may be looking to find your path to leadership because you're getting a fabulous education. You have the opportunities at your disposal. You have caring parents who ensure that you are in a place where there are nurturing teachers and making sure that it is safe for you, that you are free from harassment, that you are in an environment that is going to help you grow and develop. But what do you do with that? And I remember, and I found a picture the other day of myself as a 16-year-old high school student taking a trip to our state capitol, about a four-hour drive from my town in Buffalo, which is over near Niagara Falls. And I went on a government studies program. We literally spent a week with other students in Albany and went to the state capitol and saw how our legislators worked. And during college, I became an intern and I worked in those offices and I learned about constituent service, the importance of taking care of people's problems. And just as an 18-year-old, I had a special title and a business card. I thought that was pretty neat. And I want you to know that there are people like myself and people like Senator Liu, who's so many on this call, and all the other partners that you've spoken to, who cherish and relish the chance to embrace you. All you have to do is step forward and raise your hand. Say, I want to work during high school. I want to be an intern during college. And there are countless people who want to open that door for you. And when that door was open for me, and I had a chance to work with people as a teenager who eventually became leaders, they remembered the work I had done, volunteering for them, helping my community, helping people get elected to office. And that helped propel me to other positions. So I'm telling you right now, the doors are open. You just need to unlock the key and step in, because we want to help you succeed. You are the future leaders. There's no doubt in my mind. You've been given gifts. Education is a gift. So many young people do not have a quality education they can rely on. And the focus that we're seeing on STEM, this speaks to my heart, because I have gone to too many technology places where people are innovating with their hands and their minds, coming up with solutions for the future. And I, first of all, am not seeing enough young women out there. So I've been to countless events where we talk about getting more young women into the science and technology, engineering and math. And it just opens up a whole new world to you. Also, the ability to earn a good income so you can take care of your families. So that's what this is about. Leaning hard into those courses in high school, when you go to college, take those classes, explore them, learn how to do coding. These are just basic skills that someday that's going to be as basic as learning how to write, like it was when I was a child. So there's opportunities now. And what the Teach Coalition is doing, the Teach New York Coalition is doing, is making sure your elected officials, through your voices, are understanding the importance of continuing investments. And that's why, even during the pandemic, when all of you had to figure out how to do your Zoom education at home until you can get back into a classroom, we also continued our $30 million of funding for the STEM programs, even when our budget looked devastating. We knew that we could never stop investing in our young people's minds, because that's an investment in the future that will reap benefits, not just for you, but for our economy as we get people back to work and look for leaders like you, who may be job creators yourself someday. You may have a business and you could hire new people, or you come up with some invention. You could be part of solving the next healthcare crisis by taking STEM classes. Think about that. The people who are our heroes today are the healthcare workers, the people who spent a year in research and development coming up with a life-saving vaccine. This is extraordinary what we can do in our country. And you are part of that in a state that values what you're doing. So we're going to continue to focus to keep you safe. We're going to call out anti-Semitism wherever it rears its ugly head, I can assure you of that, and make sure that you feel safe in your schools, and that we expand our curriculum so young people everywhere understand the history and understand the stress and pressures that many are under, and visiting the Holocaust Museum as part of a curriculum. I love visiting there, because it just puts you in a place you remember the story, the history. We never forget that. And as we start seeing negativity and signs and discrimination, all of us will stand united to call it out. I want you to feel safe. I want you to feel safe and secure in your parents, that when they send you to school, that they know you're going to be okay. So we're going to continue investing in safety measures for the schools. So thank you. Thank you for stepping up. There's a lot of young people who could be doing what you're doing and they're not. You've already self-selected yourself as a leader by lobbying in Albany, whether you're going to come in person next year or you did it virtually this year. Your voices are being heard and your voices matter. So thank you, everybody. And onward to finishing up a great school year. And maybe I'll see some of you as an intern in my Albany office someday.
Thank you. Lieutenant Governor, there's over 400,000 non-public school kids in the state, over 170,000 yeshiva and day school students. We're lucky. They've met with over 90 elected officials today. You were the last meeting, you're a keynote speaker. I asked them at the beginning of the day, Lieutenant Governor, if they would want to make their voices heard and cheer and hear everything. All the students to take yourself off mute and come and speak out, Lieutenant Governor.
Ooh. Let's go!
Legalize online gambling. I'm begging you.
Well, thank you.
March Madness is around the corner. We all just want that one thing.
In person next year.
Thank you so much. Have an amazing year and day and life.
Are we going to do this at
who? WTA!
Woo! University officers now at Warner, Universal, and Sony. So I was sent to them. And then, you know, and the same letter.
Okay. Thank you all for attending the mission. We're going to wrap it up. I'm looking for Sydney Altfield if she's still here. Hopefully she is.
Yes, I'm
there
here.
There she is.
Thank you, Lieutenant Governor. Thank you, Maury. Thank you, everyone, for being here. Wow, what a day. I am so thrilled that we were able to take our important mission to Albany virtually this year. Now, you've heard from elected officials today, you've met with legislators, you told them about the importance of non-public school funding, but it doesn't stop here. We need this excitement and enthusiasm to transcend from this Zoom and continue on. So join our movement, get involved, get your parents involved, like us on social media, visit our website to join the movement. It is so important to make our voices heard year round, just like you did today. Again, we thank you all for taking the time out of your days to join us. And I'll end with one last nine. Next year in Albany. Thank you all so much and have a great rest of your day. Thank you.